What's up, guys? I'm Ashley Jenkins, and 2014 has kicked off with the expiration of several Marvel video game licenses. Or at least that's what it looks like, since several games featuring Marvel heroes have disappeared from online stores like Xbox Live, PSN, and Steam. Several titles from both Activision and Capcom have been affected, specifically those featuring Deadpool, X-Men, and Spider-Man. And even Marvel vs. Capcom is now missing. Most notable of the bunch is Deadpool by High Moon Studios, which only released in June last year and is now unavailable after only 6 months on digital shelves. The games that saw retail releases are currently available in stores still, but it's likely they will also disappear once stock is exhausted. About this time last year, Activision pulled three other licensed titles featuring James Bond and stated they would be reducing their focus on licensed games. During a restructure in February, they stated, "We expect to release fewer games based on licensed properties and as a result are realigning our structure to better reflect the market opportunities and our slate. Generally, licensed games, especially those tied to movie franchises, are costly to make on short timelines and fail to impress gaming audiences. And Activision isn't the only publisher turning away from them. EA stopped making full retail games for movie licenses in 2008, and even THQ killed off its planned Avengers-based title prior to its bankruptcy. Next up, Pixel Junk Eden developer Q Games has revealed the power of Steam sales. Their game, the third in the Pixel Junk series, was released in 2008 for PS3 and Steam and came up for potential inclusion in the latest Steam holiday sale via community voting. After winning the vote, the game went on sale for 90% off for just 8 hours. And in that time, the game doubled the developer's income for the year. Exact sales figures haven't been released, but Q Games designer Dylan Cuthbert confirms, "We just made our income to date again in just 8 hours. It was a huge success." Pixel Junk Eden is a platform puzzle game that challenges players to navigate levels by jumping, swinging, and attaching to plant-like structures to collect spectra. And while we're talking digital success stories, FTL developer Subset Games has revealed a new race coming to space in their upcoming Advanced Edition expansion, which has been previously announced to include new weapons, drones, augments, systems, and opportunities to tear all your hair out in frustration. A new mind control ability will empower you to turn enemies against one another temporarily, and a new hacking system will let you sabotage enemy ships. For example, you could reverse a medbay to harm its patients rather than heal. The expansion will also add a new space sector to explore and a new story written by FTL writer Tom Joubert and guest contributor Chris Avalon, who's previously worked on Fallout New Vegas, Neverwinter Nights 2, and Icewind Dale, among many others. The new race the developers plan to unleash is called the Lanius, metallic scavengers that can survive in deep space without life support and float dormant until they sense large amounts of metal nearby, like your ship, for example. And they can drain the oxygen from any compartment they occupy. The expansion doesn't have a release date yet, but is expected early this year and will be free to those who already have FTL. It'll be a separate release for iPad. Finally, Microsoft has revealed what has previously been theorized, that they originally considered making Xbox One a digital-only console with no disk drive. What stopped them in the end was bandwidth and game size. Microsoft's Phil Spencer explains, "There was a real discussion about whether we should have an optical disk drive in Xbox One or if we could get away with a purely diskless console. But when you start looking at bandwidth and game size, it does create issues." He also explains that a lot of the online ecosystem Microsoft has built around Xbox Live for Xbox One and a lot of what's planned for the future were born from those original ideas of a digital console. One of those plans could see a return of live events like Xbox 360's 1 vs 100, which pitted gamers against one another in a real-time arena, though Spencer says that specific execution may not be what they're looking for this time. Nancy Tellem and I were discussing game shows on Xbox Live. 1 vs 100 was a success for us. Probably not 1 vs 100 exactly, he reveals. And that's the news today. Do you think going digital only would have helped or hurt Xbox One? Let us know in the comments below. Then check out roosterteeth.com for our first patch episode of 2014.